Hi students, coming to our next topic, that is the subroutines. So subroutines is nothing but it's a small program that can be called whenever we required. So instead of repeating the same program segment at all locations, these can be written and stored separately. So these subroutines can be written and stored separately, so that whenever we require, we just call that subroutine. After that, we will just return it and we will continue with the main program. So here, each such block of instructions which carries out a specific and well-defined task is called a subroutine. So the block of instruction, which carries out a specific and well-defined task is called a subroutine. Okay. So this is the definition of the subroutine. So what the subroutine will do? Actually, the subroutine will it halts the main program. Suppose the main program is executing the instructions in sequence. So whenever the subroutine is occurred, it halts the main program. Returning to the same point. It transfers control to subroutine. It executes the subroutine. After executing the subroutine, it reverts to the main routine. So these are the different steps that are taking place whenever the subroutine is occurred in the main program. It first halts the main program, whatever the instructions it is executing. Whenever the subroutine is occurred, it halts the main program. It provides the returning to the same point and it transfers the control to subroutine. It executes the subroutine and after executing the subroutine, it comes back to the main program. So this is the steps that are taking place in the subroutine. Suppose this is a main program. So let us take it is a main program. So program is executing in sequence. Whenever the call is occur, it go back to the subroutine program. After the subroutine program is over, whenever it sees the return function, return statement, it go back to the again to the main program. So still the more program is there to be executed. After that, again we call the sub program. So whenever it occurs, the statement goes to the subroutine program. It execute that sub particular function. After that, whenever it sees the return, it again go back to this the main program. After the execution of this block, again continue with the main program. So this is the way the subroutine will be called whenever it requires in the main program. So instead of repeating the same program segment at all locations, we are just written and stored separately. We are just returning and storing this program separately. Whenever we require, we just calling into the main program. So this is the way the subroutine program will be called in the main program. Thank you.